Columbus looked for precious spices when he made his westward trip, but the yearly value of all the spices in the world does not equal that of corn. We cropped the lands, we reinvested too, and most of this was good. But there were some mistakes. Yes, we made mistakes. We plowed straight up and down the hill, and every furrow was a watercourse to wash away some soil.
Come back next fall and see the corn she'll raise.
You'll be surprised at how much corn she'll raise.
Another mistake was raising corn year after year on the same ground. The test plots told us it was wrong, and we knew it was wrong. But we couldn't wait for the bigger yields from the good rotation plan. This overuse and cultivation of the land caused us to use up, to burn out the organic matter that once was in the soil. Now particles were closely packed together. The soil grew cloddy. The weight went up to 85 pounds for every cubic foot. The root-filled virgin soil of the prairie had weighed only 65 pounds for every cubic foot. The soil without its roots was an easy victim for erosion. Most of us knew this, but perhaps we did not realize how great the difference was. This was the biggest mistake of all. The soil that washed away.
You'd be surprised at how much corn she'll raise. You'd be surprised.
How many tons of upland topsoil must wash away to cut one gully on a hillside? Erosion left unchecked can rob us of our soil and our reinvestment, too. Grass roots would help to stop all this. What has happened in 100 years? The virgin prairie offered us two things, a soil and a lesson. We used that soil to grow good crops and to build ourselves a farmland. And we might have learned that the roots of a prairie plant or some newer grass was needed in our soil. 1,000 years might not erode 1 inch of soil from an unplowed field of grass. And those roots will serve to hold the soil after the field is plowed. But that isn't all. Good soil must not be closely packed. A crumb-like structure is needed for movement of both air and water. Grass roots help provide that structure in the soil. Each tiny rootlet binds small, single particles together into these crumb-like aggregates. A mass of roots can do a lot of binding, and grass has always had a lot of roots. These are the roots that can bind the soil together, yet provide the space for movement of both air and water. So goes the lesson of the prairie. But there is more. To maintain the physical condition of the soil, our modern grass does just as well as prairie grass. And it can yield a bumper crop of hay as well, or make a pasture if that is our wish. Brome grass can stand alone, but why not give it a helper? The same helper that the prairie grasses had. Legumes. We have more and better legumes now to help the grass do an even better job. Those long tap roots drive deep into the ground, much deeper than the grass roots, and then store nitrogen which the plant has gathered from the air. These plants keep adding to the soil. Grass and legumes growing together, the same team that the prairie used. One with fibrous roots to bind the surface soil, the other with its deep tap roots, which can add nitrogen. We know the lesson now. We might have learned it from the virgin prairie. Even in cultivated soil, grass roots can well be showing. A good rotation plan will keep them there. And while they show, those roots are working at the job of ensuring higher yields. To raise good corn year after year, and 100 years from now, the soil needs all the help we can give. One way of helping is to keep roots on the waterways. This is an extra job for the grass. The waterways can be combined with contour farming, and we have two ways to help the soil. Two ways that work and work together. With our improved equipment, which is built to work with contour farming, we should be able to speed up this use of a better way of farming on the slopes. A lot more farmers are going to have the satisfaction of being on the level with their land. Sometimes the job of farming on the level seems to be a pretty big one, but the bigger the job, the bigger the need for that job. A thing worth doing is worth doing well. A farm worth farming is worth farming well. A land that is covered by grass would not need much help, but cultivated ground needs all the help that we can give. It needs some systematic plan. We have so many ways to do the job that we might lose sight of this. Keep the grass roots in the soil. It won't be just lying idle, the land we have in grass. What other product of the farm can do so much to build and hold our soil and still take care of filling up the barn? We ought not to forget that grass is a crop, whether it's used for hay or for pasture. Corn or grain isn't the only feed that we give to our stock. Sometimes we get things backside front. We get to thinking that the pasture supplements the grain. Let's get things straight. Grass is a crop no matter how you harvest it. And this crop deserves as much attention, both in time and interest, as does any other crop. There will be plenty of cash returns for those farmers who raise the best of grasses and who take the time and trouble to learn of newer varieties and what they can do. The expert will work to gather his seed and to test and improve his strain. But it's up to the farmer to use the seed and to grow that better grass. The prairie grasses did a job, but they had a long, long time to do it. The grasses of today must still do the job and also fit into rotation. With legumes, too, the work goes on for a new variety of some well-known plant. Or we work with a newer type. There's a lot of promise in some of the new and performance in most of the old. There will be new varieties of an old, old team. The prairie team of grasses and legumes. The grass will be better, and the legumes better, and we know that the team is well matched. They will give us grass roots in the soil. Grass roots like those of yesterday, builders and protectors of a fertile soil. Grass roots like those we have today, to bind the soil together, yet provide the space for movement of both air and water. Grass roots of tomorrow, the key to a permanent agriculture.